given the range of issues that the late governor has worked on during his distinguished career as a policymaker, when Deputy Governor Michael Attingiego asked me to give this lecture, I had to think quite a bit about what I could focus on. I settled on what issues Governor Mutebile would have focused on to help Uganda and indeed other African countries navigate through the current rather difficult global economic conjuncture and mounting geopolitical tensions. In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic, extensive fallout from Russia's invasion of Ukraine, synchronized and marked tightening of global financial conditions, heightened macroeconomic imbalances are back with a vengeance as the first order economic priority facing many countries around the world, advanced countries, but also many African countries. The ways that these imbalances are presenting themselves and their context varies from country to country, but in the broadest of terms, imbalances have been typified by, first and foremost, surging inflation. In many of our countries here in Africa, this has mainly been on account of spillovers from international developments.
Now, this issue of consistency over the long term, which was very dear to Mutebile, is very, very important. Nothing can be as damaging as a country going through economic reforms of a decade and a half, and then to throw it away because there is a crisis. It is happening now in a number of African countries, and that means attempt to avoid short-term pain. You actually invite long-term pain and high-cost reforms in the future. Consistency and avoiding volatile policies. Now, rich countries can afford inconsistency. Just look at how they responded to the global financial crisis, nationalizing banks, printing money because they can. But we don't have that luxury. Our room for maneuver is very, very small. And therefore, consistency over long policies is absolutely critical.
Definitely, Mutebile and his group helped us because they emphasized for them. But maybe let me first go through the targets. So the second target was after reviving the small island, then the next target was to expand it. Revive the small island of money economy, and expand it. Number three, diversify the activities in the money economy. Because remember, for instance, if you those three C's and three T's were being told that these were cash products. Coffee was a cash crop. Cotton was a cash crop. But maize was not a cash crop. It was a food. So for the urban people who sometimes eat maize flour, akawunga, they are to buy it from Kenya. The Kenyan whites who are growing that maize. So